Oh my guys.
What is going on YouTube? Welcome to the channel. You guys already know we have an awesome video planned for today, but before we get started, the comment of the day is popping up, so make sure you guys subscribe, hit the bell to join the Narmy, and leave a comment down below on this video for your chance to be in next video's comment of the day. And also behind us, right here, we have Lojo. It's been way too long since we've done a fishing challenge together. So Lojo is in my neck of the woods. He came down to Florida and we are here at Walmart, guys. The plan for today, first of all, I got my idea from Kicking Their Bass TV, Lojo and I did. So what we're doing is we're going in and buying lottery tickets, $15 worth, maybe some fives, maybe some ones, I don't know. We're gonna scratch them off and then we're gonna go buy our favorite tackle with the money that we win. We can only spend money on tackle with the money that we win from the lottery tickets. So I'm hoping that like I win like $100
and Lojo
doesn't
win anything.
What if
we win like a lot of money? We may just take off and quit.
I might not spend $100 on tackle, I don't know. So Walmart doesn't have any lottery tickets, so we're gonna go over here. There's like a little gas station at Walmart and see if they have lottery tickets.
Check it out.
Man.
This is about to go down right here. Although I didn't buy $15 worth, like we said.
Wait, how many?
I spent like $12. I miscounted. I know I miscounted. So,
okay, well, we'll do yours first.
Now Norm is at a huge advantage because he has an extra lottery ticket that I don't have. Boom. Got $2 on my first one. So we're already doing pretty good because I know there's got to be some cheap lures in Walmart that I can get for $2. So that's a good start. Nice. I wasn't even recording.
Got the crossword
puzzle. This is a crossword puzzle. I don't want to sit here and do a crossword puzzle. Oh, I guess I'm supposed to go one at a time, huh?
Is he going to spell subscribe to Fishing with Norm?
Oh, maybe.
Join the Narmy.
Dang it. This is like one of those ones that old ladies get because they actually want like to sit there for a while and like make it feel like they're doing something. See, I don't like these because it's going to piss me off if I do all this work and I don't win anything. A Q, an X, and a Q. What am I supposed to do with an X and a Q on this? There's no X's or Q's. A Z! A Z! X, Q, Z. Thanks a lot. That's man. That's just what I needed. It was a Z. Good Lord.
So Lojo only won $2 in total out of every single one of these tickets.
True story.
And one of them was $2. So I've been working on mine here. I started with the $3 crossword cash vault, won nothing. But on the $3 Scrabble, I ended up winning $6 because I had three words. So those both took like 20 minutes apiece. So now we have these three left, the Monopoly Jackpot, the Neon 7, and the Money Machine. We're going to save this one for last. It's the $5 one.
I got a good feel about that money.
We got two $2 tickets left. So let's go ahead and do this.
Is that looking good?
Yeah, that's
All right, so we'll scratch off our winning numbers. We're looking for a 17 and a 1. Nothing.
Big old nothing burger.
Monopoly,
right there.
Nothing. So we still got $6. All right, Neon 7.
Flying out the window.
All right. That's it.
The last one.
Here we go. Big money right here.
Money Machine.
This is like the retirement.
All right.
Here. You can retire on
went up to
like
250
that.
Grand. All right, that's
That'd
a lot of Cinco's
good.
Right there.
Yeah, that's a lot of fish. Oh, no.
No.
Oh.
No.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, you're still in good shape though, man, compared
to
me.
So in total we spent $30 and we ended up making 8 combined.
That is gambling, kids. Don't gamble.
Do not gamble. I got the better end of it though. I got $6.
Absolutely.
And Lojo got $2. So good luck, dude. Let's go ahead and cash these in, and then we're gonna go into the tackle store and figure out what I can buy for $6 that's gonna give me the best chances of beating Lojo today.
Lojo, man. Let's see it.
Cash money.
$2.
Make the world go round,
wow.
Baby.
Imagine if you had a dollar more, you could be balling out with some Cincos.
I'm telling you, man.
But Lojo,
well, not an actual Cinco, but...
No, but
the,
you could...
The other Cinco.
You know what I mean.
The actual Cinco, we would need, like, to really hit the lottery, because these, I love them, but man, they're expensive.
Lojo only has $2 to spend, and the only thing that's cheaper than $2 in my Walmart is right down here.
Is this bargain bucket full of like random like yum lures, and I mean I like yum, but like, what is that right there? What are you supposed to do with that right there? I mean, I'm seeing some lizards, I'm seeing some worms. I don't know, man.
Dang.
There's really not a lot of stuff in here that I like to throw, but I mean, I see these lizards right off the bat. I mean, is that gonna work?
That's the move. I'd say that's the move. Lizards are the move.
Yeah, I think so too. You could rig them Texas rig, weightless or weighted, and yeah. I think they'd work fine.
Lojo had $2 to pick out his lures. Do a little selfie mode, Lojo. Show him what's going on.
Guys, you already know what time it is. This stuff right here, I'm trying to tell you. Some lizards, $2, that's all I need. That's all I need to win this challenge, and I will. All
right, so we're balling out. I got $6, not $2. I also told, look at this.
We got Lincoln.
We got Washington. You already know that we're out here having a tackle shopping spree. So I told Lojo lizards are good. They're not good. So
yeah, he probably lied to me. I said lizards will work. So yeah.
Check out this mad saving tip from your boy Fishing with Norms. So speed worms, I love them. 338 here. But check this out. When you're on a budget, you come down to the Yums. They're a little cheaper. Look at that. You even got a nice color here.
Yeah.
Look at that. Color. Same thing. But like 40 cents cheaper.
Yep. So now you're just at $3. So now
I can pick one more bait out for $3. Nice. And I'm not gonna do another soft plastic because I feel like that's cheating.
Yeah, I agree.
What you thinking, Lojo?
I'm looking at some spinner baits over here.
Yeah.
Strike King spinner bait right there, a little smaller one. You got some jigs, $2.
Huh.
Ooh. Some lipless. Well, that's lipless.
Ooh,
crank.
I could go lipless crank. This is actually a cool lipless crank bait, dude. Look at this. For $2.50. It's like chartreuse and black.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
With a red eye.
That's pretty cool.
$2.50. Should I do it?
I think it looks pretty awesome. I mean, it's kind of on sale too, so you could, you know, save a little bit of money. So even with tax, yeah, you're coming in under $6.
Under $6.
Yeah.
So yeah, nice. We got.
Show us what you got.
The Yum Swimming Dinger.
Okay.
And we also have the little chartreuse in black with the red eye.
That thing's
lipless
cool
crankbait.
Looking. I don't care.
It honestly looks awesome.
That thing's pretty cool.
It's like the coolest lipless crankbait I've ever seen.
What brand is that?
Bomber. I've never even heard of it.
Bomber. We're going to put that to the test.
It's going
to
be the bomb. So, all right.
Nice. Okay.
Let's go check out.
Hey, let's get out of here.
All right, folks. We made it out to the pond. Lojo and I here. He's throwing the lizard. And I'm starting out with the Yum Swimming something other. I don't know. It's like a speed worm. That's what I'm going to call it. In watermelon red. And we got this juicy little golf course pond. We're going to see if we can't pull out a few fish out of here. This pond's known for smaller fish. But there's some big ones in here, and then we're gonna go to like a big bass pond to end it off. I'm excited. Let's start fishing. There's normally like 20 to 15 fish just sitting on that log. Oh, I got one. There we go. It feels like a little bit of a better one for out here. That's a good one for out here. There we go, guys. Fish number one. Lojo, you better watch out. Well, before I talk, I better land it. That's a good fish for out here. That's a better fish for out here, dude.
Nice.
Check that out, guys.
Were you just swimming or were you bouncing it?
Bouncing it. That's a Sally. See ya, Sally.
I'm going to go ahead and make a cast right here.
Go for it, man. You got one?
Yep.
There you go.
There he is.
Lojo's on, folks. Will he tie it up?
Buddy.
Little guy.
Come on in.
Nice, Lojo. Lizard fire.
$2 lizard, baby.
Can't let me get ahead for too long. Lojo's
nice,
already
nice,
slamming
nice,
one.
Nice.
Oh, wow. As soon as we leave, dude, I just saw like 4 bait fish. Oh, I got one.
Uh-oh.
There we go. There we go. Fish number 2, guys.
Oh, I got one too.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh, the double up. The double up. Okay. Mine's in. Nice, dude.
That's how you double up in a Florida golf course pond right there, baby, on some cheap lures.
Just when I thought I was taking the lead, Lojo decides to make a double up play. Double
right
fish
there.
Action. You know what? We're going to get the Snapchat really quick. Add your boy on Snapchat, at Fishing with Norm.
Get the snap. Oh, you know what? I need to take one too now.
There you go. Lojo's got a Snapchat too. Add Lojo on Snapchat. He doesn't Snapchat
enough.
Like I Snapchat,
no,
though.
I don't snap enough.
I'm always snapping.
I'm going to Snapchat you while you Snapchat me.
All right. Are you Snapchatting?
Oh God, hold on. How do I turn the camera around?
Let him go.
Go grow, guys, grow.
Get bigger for real. All right, no messing around. We gotta get back out there. 2-2. You got, oh no, Lojo has number 3. Oh, he went airborne. It was Air Bud the fish. Oh, there he is, fish number 3. All right, there we go. Tied it up, little squeaker. We found the stump out there though, guys.
Yeah, we found right out here, there's some deep water, a deep drop off, and then they're just sitting there.
My buddy told me it's about 20 feet out there, and we're just dragging these worms and lizards in about 20 foot of water.
That's summertime fishing right there, man. Yep. Dragging a Texas rig off of a ledge.
All right, all tied up. Lojo snapped off those, so we're going to run up to the truck and get him another Texas rig.
Dude, that one got hit as soon as it hit the water, and that's a better fish.
Oh, jeez. Super deep. Uh-oh. Lojo's got number four, and I snapped off.
Biggest one of the day, dude.
Heck yeah, man.
That's a fish. Got one. There we go, tying it up. 4-4, baby. Yes.
Oh yeah, look at that, that's a fat one too. Nice, 4-4.
Oh, I got one. There we go. Oh, it's a nicer one, dude. Uh-oh. Tied it back up 5-5.
Oh man, oh man.
Yeah, that's like a 3-pounder right there.
Oh, I know that tied things back up. Lojo caught one over there, guys, and I caught this one. It's 5-5. All right. Perfect hook set, too. Look at that fish. That's all of 3 pounds. Look at that mouth. Annihilated it. Annihilated it, Lojo.
If I had my phone, folks, you know I would take the Snapchat. You gotta add me at Fishing with Norm. All my social media is Fishing with Norm. My Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat,
all that stuff. So make sure you guys check it out after the video. But it's not a bad one. Yes. 3-pounder. Boom. Just like that, man.
All right, folks. So me and Lojo both caught one fish at the bonus pond, the big fish pond. All right. But here's the deal. So Lojo caught his fish first.
That's right.
I caught my fish second on a yum dinger because we left all of our baits at the last pond. Now, here's what I want to ask you guys. My fish was bigger. We went to the big fish pond.
But mine got caught first.
But his was caught first, and it was on the lizard and not a Cinco.
True.
I caught mine on the Cinco. So, I don't know. We're going to go talk about today. We're going to Wingstop, right?
Yes.
Wingstop.
Yes. We got to eat,
oh,
man.
It sounds so good. We've been fishing all day. We're hungry. We're big boys. So, we're going to go to Wingstop. I'll bring you guys along with us. We're going to talk about the fishing today, kind of how we were catching those fish. Some insider tips with Norman Lojo. Who doesn't want to get at? Lojo and I both caught 5 fish each. May I mention my fish was the biggest. But
again with the biggest fish.
So basically how we caught both of our fish today, or at least how I caught my fish, was on the worm. I didn't even bother throwing the lipless crankbait just because I knew I wasn't gonna get bites. It's summertime fishing, the fish are out deep. Yep. You gotta drag those worms, as painful as it is, that's what we were doing today. Lojo, what were you doing today? Was
same
that same thing?
With my lizard, and I mean, we found that ledge right off the bat. Like, and we, how many fish did we catch off that one ledge? Like
a ton,
3 or 4 each, you know? So we found that deep water, that's right where they were stacked up, so.
Exactly, in the summertime, guys, pro tip, you gotta slow down. You're probably missing a lot of fish if you're throwing moving baits in the summer. But like a month from now, fall fishing is gonna be absolutely insane. That's when we're gonna pick up the moving baits. It's gonna get totally intense. But thank you guys so much for watching the video. Lojo, how many likes for the video? For the video?
1,000 for sure.
1,000 likes, okay. Yeah. I don't know about 1,000, but let's see if we can do it. The Narmi is very strong, so guys, 1,000 likes. If you made it to the end of the video, obviously you enjoyed it. So me and Lojo are gonna sit here, chow down on some Moe's. My Moe's is getting cold. You wanna fish bump them out? Fish bump?
We out.